Hi there.
Hi.
Welcome to Deep Dive.
My name is Kelly.
And my name is Jesse. And for those of you that watch us during our Monday Minute series, we've decided to do a longer series called Deep Dive, where we actually go in and explore a complete module or a topic or an activity that may take a little more detail. So today we're going to start with the Advanced Cataloging Editor. So Kelly, let's show people, number one, how they can turn that on if they're not using it.
Yeah, absolutely. So as Jesse said, this is the Advanced Cataloging Editor. We are going to go into our Global System Preferences. I think I'll just type in Advanced, use that search. And the System Preference is called Enable Advanced Cataloging Editor. Once this has been enabled, then you will see the option within the cataloging module.
Perfect. So now we're going to roll over to cataloging. And for those of you that have been using Koha for years, know that, you know, creating a new record takes you to the basic editor where you have multiple tabs, a very detailed interface, and you can go through and manually create that record. One of the highlights with the advanced editor is the availability to use your keyboard. So shortcuts, tabbing through fields, and really getting a minimalistic look to add those fields into your record. So Kelly, let's start by taking a look at that advanced editor.
So here we are in the advanced editor page. It definitely looks a lot different than the basic editor. So if you're not familiar with this, Jesse has called this the clean slate of cataloging. So you just have your bare minimum and it's up to you to fill in that information.
So Kelly and I are going to give a deep dive of some of the great features that are in here that will allow you to customize that record. Kelly, I think one of the big features here is the keyboard functionality. So let's show the keyboard shortcuts first.
Absolutely.
There's several that are built into the system. So like Control D is inserting a delimiter. Enter moves you to the next line, you know, tabbing through moves you to the next position in the record. You'll notice there's a link at the top that allows you to redefine your shortcuts. If we click on that, that actually takes us into administration.
We can redefine the shortcuts. Ooh.
And this does allow you to go a little bit deeper. So if you're used to using something in your system, you can actually redefine them. Now this redefines them for your entire system, not just for the user, but everybody in the Koha system that's using it. So again, this does give you the option to do it.
This is found in the administration area. So if you go straight there, you'll find this under additional parameters is the keyboard shortcuts.
The next thing you'll see if we move our way left, there's a dropdown for alerts. If when you're saving a record in the system and you have the incorrect syntax, you're missing a subfield, whatever it may be, it will give you an alert and you'll be able to see that information there, what the error was.
That's super helpful.
Our next dropdown is going to be settings. Settings allow us to, number one, switch to the basic editor. So if you want to move back to the basic editor, this will allow you to switch between the two. One piece of advice, remember to save your record before switching to the basic editor or you will lose any of the documentation that you've created.
That's a good reminder. Other ones that are really helpful are making your text size smaller or larger. So if you want to have a larger size text, you can certainly change that to be bigger than the normal text. And you can change your font. So let's make it fun. Okay.
Our next section is macros. Think of macros like text strings. This allows you to create a way for you to run a particular script and add it directly into your record. What this will allow you to do is go in and actually run those fields so it adds it directly into your record. So if we hit that run macro, it will add that directly into the record itself.
I don't know how many times I actually hand wrote RDA when I didn't find them in a record. A macro is super helpful and super convenient if you're always finding yourself adding the same information to every record.
Absolutely. Why don't we go through adding a macro right now?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm going to hit this new macro over here on the left, give it a name. So maybe we'll do one that we could run for suppressing a record. So we remember that that is in the 942N with a value of 1 will suppress a record. So let's go ahead and add that. So I'm going to say new 942. So I'm giving it a new field 942 equals. Shortcut there was my control D will give me the delimiter.
Awesome.
And it will be the N subfield and the value of 1.
Okay. And now when we run that macro,
we can add that in and there it is.
Perfect. Okay. The next button you'll see is the option to import a record. This allows you to import either a .mrc file or a .markxml file. So let's say we've grabbed a record from another library, we've used MarkEdit, we've got something from our vendor. If we want to bring one of those records in, this allows us to import it. So you can see Kelly grabbed a .mrc file from her desktop and brought that record directly in. So this is a great way to do one record rather than using the tool module to bring in multiple.
Yeah, this is great for just that example, like just one record. I just have to grab this one record for a variety of reasons, but that will be super helpful.
Now, the next button you'll see is save to catalog. That allows us to save that record right away. If we have any errors, it will give us errors. If she hits that drop-down menu, we're going to see there's ways for us to, number one, duplicate it. So for those of you that use the edit drop-down menu, we have that edit duplicate as new. This gives us that same feature and functionality.
And then save to catalog is a major search, but you also have that option here. So lots of ways to save it. We should probably just save this one and then start a whole new record, but we do have a new record if we wanted to, but I haven't saved it yet. So I have to remember that.
Okay. Now let's talk a little bit about errors, Kelly. If you go to save your record and there's an incorrect syntax or a missing field or a duplicate field that shouldn't be there, Koha will give you a message. It will be in red, letting you know that that particular field is incorrect or there's a duplicate subfield or a missing field. So in this case, Kelly removed that 003. It's telling us right away. Record structure invalid, cannot save, missing controlled field contents. So we can see right away exactly what that error is.
And it brings you right to that line, kind of, it gives you an indication. And as Jesse was saying earlier, alerts, we will have an alert here. Any of our alerts as we go through this process will be stored here through this record.
Excellent. Okay, so now let's go in, let's update that and try saving one more time. Awesome. So now we've created a new record. You'll notice right away it gives us that unique bibliographic record number 26126. I can jump right in to view that record or edit items directly from the screen.
Yeah, I like that. So view will just bring me to that bib record that we always see when we're searching. And then edit items, if you're using the basic editor, you know that this will bring you right to the ability to add that physical copy to this record.
Kelly, let's show them a few more options on this main page. So talk to us about if our cursor is in the advanced cataloging editor in a specific field. When we click on that field, show us where we can find that question mark that we're used to in the basic editor.
Absolutely. So I'm going to, nicely, it opened in a new tab. So I'm going to go to my other tab. And as I'm standing. I'm putting my cursor, and you can see it flashing maybe in the 245. Just like in the basic editor, you do have the ability to see what that information is in the Library of Congress. So I have the mark field at the very bottom in a blue box, and then that question mark, which will bring me right to the Library of Congress. Again, opening a new tab. So if I was unsure what information should be stored there, if I really need that information for this record, I can come over here and kind of figure that out.
Excellent. some of the other nice features too, like if you need to adjust something in your fixed data fields, or a great example in the leader, if you're changing it to like an audiobook, you can go in there, select one of those fields, and it will populate a drop-down menu for you to make those changes right directly within that record.
So here I am. You'd have to know the position they are as you start to learn this without the helpers that the basic editor gives you. Once you know the positions that you want to fix, it will go a lot smoother, but you do have the ability to certain positions in both the leader and in the fixed 008 field, you can have those drop down or helpers.
Let's talk about the clipboard now, Kelly. So we saw in those keyboard shortcuts, we do have options to essentially copy things or delete things and copy it to the clipboard. This would be a great opportunity for you if you're editing a record and you need to make some changes. You can easily do that by copying that information over to the clip field you see there on the left-hand side.
Mm-hmm. This is your clipboard. This is relatively new, and I know a lot of libraries that are using this feature to be able to, in essence, pull it out, resolve it, and then put it back in.
Fabulous. I think the last thing we should talk about here is the integration of the Z3950 server. So on your far right-hand side, you'll notice that search box. This will allow you to do a keyword search, title search, scan that ISBN number in or an author search, and it will bring up your Z3950 server. Or we can hit that advanced button, and this will open a modal window where we can now see the advanced Z3950 search. One of the real key features here is the availability to search your local catalog. So we're also searching the Koha system.
I had no idea. I had no idea that that was a thing. So, wow.
This is great for consortias too, because if you're searching for something and you want to make sure that another library doesn't have it first, where you might just be adding the item, this gives you the opportunity to do it.
Well, let's do this, Jesse. Let me close this out. I'm going to hit this new record, and we'll do the whole process from using that Z39.50 search.
Perfect.
So I have an ISBN, and I could scan it in now, but I want to hit that advanced because maybe I wanted to pick and choose what servers I was looking at, or I wanted this picture because I'm more comfortable this view, whichever.
I want to hear your scanner go off.
Okay, there you go. Never leave home without it. Or never leave home to a trainee without it. And I didn't get any records.
Aww. Is it a new book?
Well, I had a concern because it's paperback, but I feel like she doesn't even publish in hardcover, I don't think.
Okay, well, let's go ahead.
Let's try again. Let's just do her the party of two.
There we go. Now, a few things that you'll notice if you're used to using the Z3950 server in the basic editor. This view only has a mark view and the import option, where with basic, we have that ISBD view. If we hit that view mark button.
Who uses that ISBD view though, Jesse? I'd love to hear from people.
I always do, because you know, sometimes it's easier to look there to see if it's an audio or not, just the way it's been cataloged.
Interesting. I've never done that mm-hmm. way. Okay, so I'm going to hit that view mark. As you were saying, it's going to show up within the actual source box. So I know that this is coming from the Seattle, which is completely different from the basic editor. You click and then you have another pop-up. So you have a pop-up on a pop-up, and that's confusing.
And this is nice, it's right within it. Mm-hmm. So if we find the title that we want, we can click that import key right on the right-hand side, and that's gonna bring it directly a copy into our catalog.
That first one was an ebook.
Okay.
So I'm gonna go grab this one. Look at that.
Perfect. So you can see how easy it is that it brings it in. You know, if you wanna get rid of some of those 938 fields, this gives you the opportunity where you can highlight those, remove them.
I can say that that's a lot faster than the basic editor.
Yeah, for sure. And if we needed to, we could run some of those macros at this point, although this one already has your 336 and, you know, 337 and 338. But again, if you had created macros, making it very easy, this is the way to do it.
Yeah. Another great macro would be adding that 942C, just having, you know, book, audiobook. So you could hit that in really easily.
And that gives you the drop-down menu too. So if you have 20 to 30 item types, you have the option to select from the, look at that. Perfect.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm just going to go ahead and add that delimiter C, and then I have the ability to add my biblio item type.
Perfect. All right. Well, we want to say thank you for joining us for the first session of Deep Dive. If you have suggestions for us of something that you would like to see a more in-depth run through in any of the modules in Koha, please let us know.
Yeah, absolutely. We love your feedback. So thanks for watching.
Have a great week.
Have a great week.